Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. I hope you are having a wonderful day. In today's video, we're going to be doing a book review for Allie Hazelwood's Love on the Brain. This was my September choice for book of the month. And yeah, I had to read this book twice. Well, the first time I started reading it, I got to chapter 3. I was bored, so I stopped reading it and picked up other things to read. Then I was like, Jasmine, you gotta read it because it's probably a slow build and it's probably gonna get good. So then I sat down and read the book from cover to cover in about a week. It was very good. There was a plot twist involved that I did not see coming. It really started to get good when I hit chapter 5. So, Love on the Brain is a romance book. Y'all know that's my favorite genre of books. And it combines my love of science with my love of books. So, I was happy about that. But I would still have to give this book a 3 out of 5. Because if you're like me and you're not pre-warned that it was a slow build book, and knowing that it didn't get good till chapter 5 made me give this book a 3 out of 5 stars. But the plot twist was really good. I'm not even going to dive into that in this review, but just know there's a plot twist. So let me read you the back of the book. B's theory was right. Forcing a scientist to work with her nemesis triggers explosive results. Like an Avenger purple-headed Jedi bringing balance to the men's spine. B's theory was right. Forcing a scientist to work with her nemesis triggers explosive results. Like an Avenger purple-haired Jedi bringing balance to the men's spine universe. Being Kirawasser lived by a simple code. What would Marie Curie do? If NASA offered Marie her dream neuroengineering job, she would accept it without hesitation. Duh. But the mother of modern physics had never had to co-lead with Levi Ward. Sure, Levi had soul-piercing eyes, and sure, he caught her in his powerful poet arms like romance novel heroes when she accidentally damseled in distress on her first day at the lab. But Levi made his feeling toward being clear in grad school. Arch nemesis work best when employed in their own galaxies far, far away. Now her experiment ignores her staff, and B finds herself floundering career in somewhat of a pickle. Perhaps it's her occipital cortex playing tricks on her, but B swears she can see Levi softening into an ally, backing her play, devouring her with those eyes, and the possibility has all her neurons firing. But when it comes to making a move and put her heart on the line, there's only one question that matters. What will B. Kirawasser do? Okay, so that was the back of the book. Now B is a scientist. She works for the NIA, and her arch enemy, Levi Ward, works for NASA. And NASA and the NIH have to come together to create a helmet for the astronaut. So that's how Levi and B became co-leads on this project. But B and Levi previously knew each other in grad school, and B and Levi have been arch enemies since grad school. B has it in her head that Levi doesn't like her, based off of things he have said about her and why he going to have to read that part yourself, because I don't want to spoil that for you. But Levi, on the other hand, he's like, I don't understand all the tension between us just because I don't want to work with you. This is why you act the way you act, because I don't want to work with you. And then in this science world, in this book, gender roles play a big part, because the men in NASA don't want to listen to me because, one, she's not a part of the NASA team, she's from the NIA, so they feel as though they don't have to listen to her because she's only consulting and co-leading on the project, because they're handling this project at NASA, so she's not on her home turf, and because she is a woman. And she has this fascination with this scientist from years ago named Marie Curie, and how she broke a lot of gender stereotypes in the science community and did a lot to progress women in the field of STEM in general. So she has this Twitter account called What Would Marie Curie Do, where they talk about science and things that's happening in the STEM world. And it's mostly how women are not treated as equal. And she communicates with her Twitter followers. Nobody really knows who's behind the Twitter account, so nobody knows it's really her. And then she conversates with this other Twitter account. She's never met this person. It is a guy. And they're both complaining about their job. He's complaining about funding that went towards his project, and she's complaining about her co-leader and working for NASA and how she's not respected as a woman in the field of science, but she's more so not respected as a co-lead on this project because most of the team at NASA are men. And then her project is close to being shut down. They're doing everything they can to boot her own project. But Levi is not having it. So he kind of defends her, because to Levi, this project has personal reasons behind why this project has to be successful. She's thinking, oh, this has to do with more of your career, because your career is already great and you want to be known as the best engineer. But for Levi, it is personal. And somehow along the way, I won't tell you how, their worlds intertwine, because B has a condition where if she's still anxious or nervous or has some sort of anxiety, she passes out, or she can randomly faint because she suffers from low blood pressure. So how their worlds intertwine, and she realized she needs him as an ally if people are going to respect her on this project. Now the plot twist. I'll just say, when it comes to the plot twist, there is a specific reason why they are giving her a hard time about this project. That's all I'm going to say on the plot twist. I had to read the book to find out the plot. But I would say my biggest takeaway from this book is, if you think a person does not like, I would say don't make an assumption of why they don't like you. Ask them. Anything you want to know, you should be able to ask a person. Now, I can't guarantee they are going to give you the answer you want to hear, or actually honest with you, but it's better to ask the question than to assume what their answer is going to be. And the other takeaway that I get from this book is that whatever field you decide or career path you decide to take on in your life should not be dictated by your gender. There are a lot of women in science that are amazing and are just as good or even better than some men science. So when it comes to working in the field, people should be getting paid for their work, not because of their gender. So if you are a doctor and you are a male doctor, women and male doctors should be getting paid the same rate for doing the same job. That goes for any career, and in science too. Any career, women and men should be getting paid the exact same for doing the exact same job. And all the gender choices when it comes to what career field you're in or anything you're doing. This book was an eye-opener to how far women have come in certain fields, but how far we're still away from getting equal pay and equal opportunity. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Remember, I'm always thinking of you, sending my love, and bye for now.